Welcome back to Oso Farm. Today is Saturday, February 27th, and we just got our monthly supply of primarily Ezra's medical supplies and incontinence supplies, and then we also get a monthly supply for Evan of just diapers. Silver shelves that we got at, I think, either Sam's Club or Costco, and they work really well to hold all this. These are Evan's pull-ups and Ezra's diapers. Ezra's currently transitioning from a size small to a size medium, so we actually got two sets. I'm not sure why we got double diapers this time, but maybe there was some confusion since we changed sides. And then we get chub pads for both boys, and chub pads are just plastic on one side and a cottony kind of absorbent padding on the other side, and they're pretty good size. So we use them to lay underneath when we're changing a diaper. We wrap Ezra in them when we're rolling him, changing a diaper. We use these for lay underneath him when we bathe him. In our current house, we do not have a place to bathe Ezra outside of a sponge bath. So in the meantime, until we can remodel this house to accommodate his disability, we will be using these for that also. Ezra has a trach, and most of his medical supplies are related to that. Ezra sleeps on a ventilator at night. We can show you that in his room. Every month we get these circuits. These circuits go from the ventilator to his trach and are attached by these that connect to the circuit and then to his trach. Lots of gear. He is suctioned, and we get a canister, God bless you, a canister for his portable and stationary suction, and it comes with lids and tubing. Here's the tubing. We have kind of a stockpile of things, and so it gets a little bit overwhelming if it's not organized well. These are just 2x2 gauze sponges that are split. They go where his trach stoma is. The stoma is a little hole, and this collects secretions and just kind of protects that area. Kind of leaves a little barrier. And then just a lot of little things. We did not get these this month. As I'm unpacking, I'm realizing that. These go to his pull socks. We connect to his toe, so he's monitored. His heart rate and oxygen saturation are monitored anytime he's asleep. He does require oxygen when he sleeps. Wipes, we get saline bullets. They help with suctioning if his secretions are thick, and we also mix these with his albuterol and hypotonic saline for a breathing treatment. He gets 2 breathing treatments a day. And then these are HMEs that he will not wear. Little stinker. They hook on to his trach here, and then it is just a barrier so that debris and, you know, anything, does it get dirty? Then it has a little hole here that you can put the suction catheter in. This is actually great. If he would wear this, he would not dry out as much as he does. And these are single time use, so you throw those away after you use them. We get a ton of these cotton applicators. It's just like a Q-tip that we do when we do trach here and clean it, and then help him when he needs a clean out. And then these are posy trach ties. Just makes the trach almost like a little necklace. The trach has two openings on each side, and then this just hooks here and then holds the trach in place. We also use these sort of MacGyver style to keep all of his things attached to his wheelchair. I think there's anything. Oh, he is on complete nutrition through formula. We just switched this month to this Pediasure reduced calorie. Ezra was 63 pounds when we moved here last May, and he's had a huge jump in weight. He's 88 pounds now in less than a year. So that's more than 20 pounds, if I'm doing math correctly. So there is some concern with his, is it not 20 pounds? How much is it?
I wasn't listening.
63 pounds to 88 pounds.
Yeah, that's 25 pounds.
25 pounds. So his endocrinologist is really concerned. He has osteoporosis and brittle bones. He has had one spinal fracture. Also, most of his fractures are in his legs. They're thinking all the weight up here, he's paralyzed from about the waist down. His spinal cord opening, his myelomeningocele was L1 to S1. If you're familiar with how the spine is labeled, that huge part was where his paralysis started. All that to say, we're trying to not make him lose weight, but not allow him to gain weight at such a quick rate. And then also his A1C, he is pre-diabetic. That's a new finding for us. We're switching to this formula. It has the same nutrition, but 400 less calories a day. He will get 6 bottles of this a day. These are 8 ounces each. Gosh, I just went to the eye doctor yesterday and had to get bifocals. I'm feeling old. I'm gonna try to not make this look like I can't see this. I have no idea how many calories this is. Oh, 150 calories. I think his other one was 240. The hope is we'll be on this diet all of March, and then we go back to the endo in mid-April, and we'll rerun the A1C, and then also he wore a glucose monitor, and he did great overnight, but he definitely had spikes after he ate. We're gonna hopefully that this will solve the problem enough so that we don't have to treat diabetes. I'm not gonna try to shove that back in there. Anyways, this is our garage. It is not picked up by any means. It is, I think I said this at the beginning, end of February. We have been paid for the month of March. This is kind of a bizarre grocery time because we lost a lot of groceries. Not a lot. We lost a whole refrigerator, freezer inside. And then there was some panic that there wasn't going to be groceries. I had my sweet friend Jessica, who's like family to us. She drove 6 hours in one day, 3 hours each way from Houston last week, and brought us all kinds of produce and some bread and stuff from Sam's Club. And then I went to Aldi with Emma and got a few things. At some point this weekend, I will take inventory of everything that we have and do that grocery haul for the month. But this is just what we keep out here. We don't come out here every day to get things. His nurse will come out here to kind of stock him for the day and for the weeks. We will show you inside in Ezra's room and in his storage closet adjacent to his room how we keep and store his everyday supplies.
Thank you.
we are back inside. It is a little bit later this evening, and we're back in Ezra's room. Got Evan here. He is exploring all of Ezra and his toys. Can you say hi? We were just singing. Can you see? Can you show him? Daddy finger, can you see? Where are you? Here I am, do you do? Sister finger, where are you? Here I am, do you do? Good job. Can you say bye? Bye-bye. Bye-bye. We cut his hair today, and sensory-wise, it sent him over the edge. When he falls asleep, we're gonna have to just kind of trim up some of these. He's got some kind of longer back to Ezra's room. Here is his ventilator. So this was the circuit that we showed you outside that we just changed. Brian got it all changed out for the day. And this is his safe sleep bed. This railing comes down. We're washing his sheets right now, so he's got but he's got a really nice waterproof mattress. This is his Hoyer lift. It goes up to 400 pounds. Where I actually just picked this up to shoot the video in here, but he just wanted a place to sit. You have Mickey? Can you give Mickey a hug? Can you give Mickey a kiss? Oh goodness. This is how we lift Ezra without doing a two-person lift. He's in a sling that's kind of like a hammock that hangs and connects here. And then you use this and it pumps it up here, raises him. When we're getting him out of bed, we push this in. And then there's a little knob here that when you press it, it lowers it down, and then we can get him out of the sling, in and out of bed that way. And then he has all of his supplies that we use on a daily basis and a weekly basis, I guess, organized here. This is just a shoe rack, and then there's no light in this closet, so it's going to be dark, but this is just like a drawer organizer. We keep his trach and his step down trach, medicine cups, more trachs. This is for his breathing treatments, and then all the extra catheters and tubing, gloves, oxygen, extra oxygen tanks, vent batteries. And we keep his diapers in this little organizer that's not quite, can't support anything heavy. Brian.
What are we saying?
What are we saying at the end?
So of all the things in this room, Ezra's favorite thing is his Rachel. Rachel is a... What is Rachel?
She is a... She sings and teaches children how to use sign language.
Yep. Rachel Coleman, she has some videos out. It's called Signing Time. And when Ezra was real little, he learned sign language and was able to sign dad and mom and bottle and things like that. He watched Rachel on an iPad. The older that he got, the stronger he got, and just kind of, there was a challenge because he would break the iPad either by throwing it or pounding on it. His favorite thing for Rachel to do was sing. He loved the songs, and so we decided to get him a Bluetooth speaker and connect Rachel to via iPad or
his speaker.
To a speaker. And so he has a speaker. It looks like this thing. And so Ezra does this all day, and he just rocks out to his Rachel. And he loves it, and we don't go anywhere without it.
And we have multiple.
Because if we go anywhere without this, we might not survive the day.
True. Okay, Evan, can you say bye? Say bye. Say thank you for watching.
Bye.
Bye. See you next time. See you next time. Thanks for watching another episode. If you can give us a thumbs up and subscribe. We are almost to 70 subscribers, and a reminder, at 500, I get to choose a smaller livestock animal. Bigger than a goat, but smaller than a horse.
Much smaller than a horse.
So it's kind of a fun little family thing we're doing, is counting our subscribers, and that'll be our little rewards. We would love it if you would follow along. If we can pray for you, we would love to do that. You can leave us a comment below or email us, and we've left our email down in the descriptions. We will see you in the next.